respect your ears, you know, respect your body, respect your ears. I wasn't respecting my ears. My name's Simon Baker. I'm a craniosacral therapist from London. Worked in the music industry for 15, 20 years.
Our definition of safe listening is based both on the loudness of the sound and the duration of the exposure. So the WHO defines the upper limit of safe listening as 80 decibels for 40 hours a week.
About the same as a food blender, but if you're exposed to that sound for more than 8 hours over the course of a day, that's when damage can start to occur. And as the volume increases, the kind of length of time of safe exposure decreases quite dramatically. Quite an easy way to tell if you're out and about is if you're trying to have a conversation with someone who's about 2 meters away and you're having to shout for them to hear you. Lots of live venues or clubs will have sound levels at around 100 to 110 decibels. You realise that you can't actually be in these environments for too long without risking damage occurring.
I can remember people used to walk into the DJ booth and be like, you know, why are they so loud? And I just felt that that was the way that I was connecting with the music, I guess. I tried using ear protection, like molded earplugs that help DJs still hear the music, but they cut out certain frequencies. And I tried using them and I just felt really disconnected from the music and disconnected from the crowd. So I tended not to use them, and I guess really by doing that my tinnitus probably got worse, and I eventually went for some hearing tests and I was told that I'd lost some top end frequencies.
You don't listen to your device over 60% of the maximum output level. Another important tool is that now built into a lot of devices, there are alert systems that will tell you whether or not you're listening too loudly for too long of time.
Also, if you listen to music where there's lots of background noise, say on public transport, it's really important to try not to increase the sound to drown the background noise out, because you can actually be increasing your headphones to quite a dangerous level without realizing.
If I could go back, I would certainly change and realize it, not everything needs to be hammering levels in order to hear music properly.